Yvonne Romaine was a really talented actress, but as most actresses do, she also felt obligated to put her focus on raising a family rather than appearing in films and traveling. Even after her husband was rumored to have an affair with his ex-wife, Romaine still didn't give up on her married life with him. But in the end, was this all worth it for her? Continue watching to find out. Romaine started her career in Italy. Romaine was born in 1938 in London and is a graduate of the Italia Conti Academy. From the young age of 12, she was already appearing in children's shows, and by the time she was in her late teens, she was appearing in several British films. During this period, Romaine studied at the Italia School of Acting and appeared with various famous actors and celebrities. Her exotic, dark looks and perfect figure made her easily cast in supporting roles as Italian or Spanish maidens in war films and even comedies. However, it is for her roles in numerous British horror films that she is most remembered for. She enjoyed parts in Corridors of Blood, where she starred alongside Boris Karloff and Christopher Lee, and also the 1960 film Circus of Horrors. She was also to star in The Devil Doll, which was released in 1964 and was a film about a malevolent ventriloquist's dummy. She acted alongside some of the most famous actors. Romaine is probably best known for The Curse of the Werewolf, where she starred with Oliver Reeve in his first major role. In the film, Romaine plays a mute servant girl who spurns the advances of the sadistic Marquess. She is thrown into a prison cell with a deranged beggar who proceeds to do harmful things to her. As a result, she later gives birth on Christmas Day to future lycanthrope Leon, though the effort of birth later kills her. Hammer Films' publicity mostly revolved around Romaine's obvious charms by having her photographed in typical Scream Queen poses alongside actor Oliver Reed. The actors both posed together despite the fact that she and Reed shared no actual screen time during the movie. Her biggest role was in yet another Hammer production titled Captain Clegg, otherwise known as Night Creatures in the United States. Here, Romaine played alongside Peter Cushing and Oliver Reed again. This time, the actor was her fiancé. She also appeared alongside Sean Connery twice in Action of the Tiger and the gangster film The Frightened City, both released in the late 50s, early 60s. During these films, Romaine shared equal billing with the Bond star before her. The actress then went on to co-star in the Danger Man episode titled Sabotage in 1961, and in the 1964 mystery film Smokescreen alongside Peter Vaughn. But Oliver Reed would still be Romaine's most frequent co-star. The two appeared together again in an episode of The Saint in Season 2, Episode 9 called The King of the Beggars, and for a fourth and final time in The Brigand of Kandahar, released in 1965. Romaine called the movie she filmed with Elvis dreadful. Soon after, Romaine moved to Los Angeles and starred alongside Anne Margaret in the 1966 film called The Swinger, and alongside Elvis Presley in Double Trouble in the following year. She later said that Double Trouble was a dreadful film, though she enjoyed the experience. After taking a break from the screen for several years, Romaine emerged from semi-retirement as the title character in the Anthony Perkins, Stephen Sondheim scripted mystery thriller The Last of Sheila in 1973. This was also her last screen role, being only 37 years old. When it comes to her personal life, Romaine married Leslie Brickhues in 1958. He was the composer of musicals, including Stop the World, I Want to Get Off, Scrooge, and Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, as well as the lyricist for the classic James Bond theme Goldfinger and You Only Live Twice. The couple then gave birth to their son, Adam, who later grew up to become a photographer. This marriage also led her to turn down a 7-year contract with Federico Fellini because it meant working away from her Hollywood-based husband and young son. In 1969, Roger Moore became their house guest in Hollywood for the premiere of Goodbye, Mr. Chips. But a couple of months after, Romaine and Brickhues went through a terrible breakup, and even rumors spread that Brickhues had reconciled with his ex-wife. However, Romaine and Brickhues eventually reunite and celebrate a second honeymoon in Acapulco. Sadly, the actress later suffered an auto accident when she was thrown through the windshield of her car. Miraculously, her long, thick shock of hair saved her from even superficial scratches, and after several days of observation in the hospital, doctors released her with a clean bill of health. She never left her husband, no matter how hard it got. In 1971, Romaine and Brickhues suffered from yet another breakup, but managed to permanently patch up their rocky marriage for the sake of their young son, Adam. Just 3 years later, Romaine got invited to a party thrown by Vincente Minnelli and Lee Anderson at Minnelli's house for the Duke and the Duchess de Segovia of Spain, where she attended along with her husband. Soon after that, the couple purchased a fabulous villa in Malta, in which they settled. Romaine was able to stick to Brick Hughes for the rest of her life, attending many events and parties together and welcoming many celebrity guests in their Beverly Hills home. In 2003, she and her husband of over 40 years, Leslie Brick Hughes, still attend numerous social events together. In that same year, the couple also decided to move and live in the south of France for some time. In 2005, they both decided to settle in Beverly Hills again, where they still reside to this day. Do you think sacrificing a lot of things for marriage was worth it for Romaine? Or does she still partly regret not continuing her career in Europe because of her family? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out the next video in this series.